Well, greetings. This is Ralph back again, and in this video, I'm going to do a review of the Bicycle Alchemy playing card deck. Try to get it. Yeah, there we go. And this is the Alchemy 1977 England deck of playing cards. And I found out about this deck quite by accident. Somebody on Twitter recommended that I check it out, and I'm very glad she did. Because with the Alchemy deck, you've got a real different take on standard playing cards. You've got four different jokers. Let's just lay them out here. How are we doing there? One joker is looks kind of like a death card. And in tarot reading, yeah, that would definitely be a death card there. And what you can do with standard playing cards, and definitely with this deck, is you can use playing cards in a similar manner as you would tarot cards. And these jokers, I mean, they definitely give you something to think about. And that's what I like about any deck, is the way I read tarot cards, the way I read playing cards, or any other thing that I use in divination. I don't necessarily use standard textbook definitions for how to interpret the oracles. What I do is I take a look at the card or the stone or whatever it is that I'm reading, and I just let my spirit speak to me. And I ask myself, what is this object trying to say to me? And I use my intuition to try to figure it out. And so that's the attitude that I carry into doing any kind of card divination. And this definitely says to me, death. Now, death or death and rebirth, or just death. So, kind of a dark card, but interesting nonetheless. Now, you've got another card here that could very easily, this is another joker. And this card could definitely be like Wheel of Fortune, or you could also see it as the Fool. Here, the Fool is off on her bicycle, it looks like, and is out to see the world. So, either way, and different people are going to look at this same card and most likely come up with different interpretations. And since spirit speaks to us differently, depending on our different experiences and our different way of looking at things, different interpretations of the same card is definitely healthy and something to be encouraged. So, yeah, that's my take on this Wheel of Fortune, or perhaps the Fool taking off on her bicycle to see the world. Now, this is an interesting card to me. I had my wife kind of look at this, and we were both trying to give our different interpretations of it. But it's another joker, and she was thinking that this looked like the Queen of Hearts, which it definitely does. But in a standard deck of playing cards, you already have a Queen of Hearts. So I was thinking more or less along the line of, okay, this could be like a female magician, like instead of the mago, the magus, this would be like La Maga. So yeah, this would could be a female magician card. Could also be Queen of Wands, although you definitely you already will have enough queens in a standard deck of playing cards. And what else? What else came to mind with this? The magician, the High Priestess, which some people see as a counterpart to the magician. I see the High Priestess as being different, a little bit above the magician. But yeah, that meaning definitely makes sense to me too. So yeah, another interesting joker there. And then finally, the fourth and final joker in this deck of cards is something that I would call, like, again, the Fool. Or perhaps the magician, kind of a darker magician. Perhaps the magician on a bad acid trip. Who knows? If you want to get a little, facetious about it. But no, definitely you can use your imagination to interpret this in any way you would like. But yeah, I would tend to see either the fool or the magician, perhaps a dark side of the magician. Now, with the rest of the deck, I'll just kind of flip through kind of fast here. But the ace, that's the ace of spades, corresponds to swords, and I like the way in the alchemy deck they've got the correspondence correct. That's the way I interpret spades in an average deck of playing cards. That corresponds to swords in my system of thought, and the creators of this deck definitely agree with me on that. Now, one interesting thing about the alchemy deck is that the jack. Now, this is the jack. Now, again, the jack I normally tend to think of as being the knight. But here in this deck, the jacks are all feminine. So you can interpret that as being a female knight, which would fit. Or you could think of it as being the princess instead of the knight. And that's one little bit of information that I'm really not too happy about when I'm trying to interpret playing cards and interpreting them in the light of tarot cards, is that the jack could stand for the knight. It could also stand for the page. And in many tarot decks, the page is also thought of as being the princess. So here on the Alchemy tarot deck, excuse me, Alchemy deck of playing cards, you have an interpretation here that tends to favor the princess or page interpretation rather than the knight interpretation. But again, depending on your intuition and on your mood and just however your spirit strikes you, you could interpret this as being a female knight or a princess, either way. And all of the jacks in this deck definitely have that feminine quality. There is the Jack of Diamonds, and we're gonna have the Jack of Hearts. Looks like a little fairy personage there. And I think that's about all we got time for there. Here's the last jack here. That is the Jack of Clubs, which corresponds to Wands. So, and got kind of a red fiery look about that jack. So, yeah, in this deck, you could interpret the jack as being a female knight. And I think, with that card, that interpretation to me makes sense. Or the princess. Here, the Princess of Arrows. You can see that as. So, this is a fun deck. Whether you're looking for a deck of cards to play poker with, or a deck of playing cards to practice divination with, the Bicycle Alchemy 1977 England playing card deck is definitely one that you should check out. And this is fairly low price, can be found on Amazon, and is definitely a interesting deck to experiment with. So that's all we got time for this video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button if you would like. And if you do subscribe, be sure to turn on the notification bell so every time I put up new information, new videos, you will get notified. So until later, this is Ralph signing out, wishing you a pleasant day.